One of the most powerful features of Photoshop is the ability to create custom brushes, because you can create a brush from literally any photo in Photoshop. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to create a custom fog brush from clouds. Hey guys, and welcome to another Photoshop tutorial. This is Rabi from retouchstudio.com, and today you're gonna learn how to turn this image into a custom fog brush to use it on your compositing projects to replicate fog and haze and create atmosphere into a scene. So this is the image that we are going to use to create the custom brush, and the first thing we need to do is to extract this cloud from the background. And the easiest way for this type of image is to use channels. So I'm going to unlock this layer and go to channels, and the way this works is you need to choose the channel with the most contrast, in this case the red channel, and what you need to do is duplicate it by dragging it into this new layer icon. Then hit Ctrl L to bring levels, and then make the background darker by increasing the shadows with the shadows and the mid-tone sliders. But I want you to pay close attention to the edges of the cloud. If you add too much shadows, it's going to destroy the details on the edges of the cloud. And you can see that better when I turn the preview on and off. Alright, that's as far as we can go without destroying the details of the cloud. But we can still use the overlay brush technique to make the background pure black. And with that done, I'm going to click on RGB to go back to RGB mode. Then I'm going to load the red channel as a selection by holding Ctrl and clicking on the thumbnail. Now go back to the Layers tab, and with the selection active, click on the new mask icon to load the selection into the mask. I'm going to add a solid color underneath this layer so I can see a little bit better. The next thing is to desaturate the image by clicking on Ctrl+Shift+U or by going to Image, Adjustment, then Desaturate. So now you can hold Alt and click on the Layer Mask thumbnail to see the layer mask. And as you can see, the background is not 100% black, and if I take the color dropper and take a sample from here, you can see that this area is 100% black, but in here it's not pure black. So for that, I'm going to take the brush tool, reduce the flow, and then change the blending mode to overlay. And with a black foreground, I can start painting the edges to mask the background. You can see when I paint over the cloud, it is not affecting pure white. I'm going to reduce the flow a little bit more, and then I'm going to continue painting at the edges, at the same time being careful not to remove too much from the shape of the cloud. Alright, so now I can take the lasso tool and make a selection around the cloud. But we need the opposite of this selection. So I'm going to hit Ctrl+Shift+I to invert the selection. And now I'm going to fill the selection with black to hide everything except the cloud we need. Okay, now in order to convert an image to a brush in Photoshop, you need your object to be black on a white background. That's why we need to change the fill to white and also invert the image by hitting on Ctrl+I. I'm going to also crop the image, and you can access the crop tool by hitting C on your keyboard. So now go to Edit, Define Brush Preset, and you can see the preview over here, and you can rename your brush. I'm going to call it fog, and once you do that, Photoshop will automatically switch to the brush you just created. Let me show you how the brush looks like. If I click once, this is how it looks like, but if I start painting with it, it looks like this, and this does not look like fog at all. So for that, we are going to modify some brush settings. So let's load the brush settings panel, and the first thing we need to add is shape dynamics. And we will start by increasing the size jitter, and that will add variations in brush size. Next, we will need to add angle jitter, and that will make the brush rotate as you paint. And the next thing is to flip the brush on the X and Y axis. And now each time I click, I will have a different brush variation. Next, we will add some scattering, and we will increase the scatter just a little bit to add some space between the brushes, and also make sure it is on both axes. Alright, in terms of count, I usually leave it to 1 because it gives me more control to build up the effect. And the last thing is transfer, and you want to increase the opacity and the flow jitter. And what will that do is make different opacity levels in the brush strokes. You can see that in the preview down in the bottom. And I'm going to make a stroke with the brush to show you the difference. This is with the opacity jitter all the way to 0, and this is with all the way to 100, and you can see the difference there. And the same applies for the flow as well. I usually keep them both at 100% and also decrease the opacity to 20% and the flow to 10%. And that will give me more control, and it will allow me to build up the effect and create the cloud volume slowly. You can see now how it is starting to look like fog when I keep painting on top. And that's the key to this effect. You want to start with a very low opacity and flow and build up the effect. Alright, so once you're happy with the brush settings, you can actually save it as a brush preset by clicking on the hamburger menu in the brush settings panel and choose new brush preset. And from here, you can choose what to save within the brush. If you want to capture brush size, the tool settings, or the color. It will even save the settings from the options bar, like the opacity and the flow. Then you rename your brush and click OK, and it will be automatically selected and added to the brush panel as a new brush preset with the settings you saved. Now we can delete the first brush by right clicking on it and select delete brush. I also created a couple of brushes with slightly different settings and different cloud types. This one is a little bit softer. And now I'm going to drag this brush inside the fog brushes group, and I'm going to also provide them for you to download. Now let's put this into action and see how we can use this brush in some case scenarios. So I have a landscape photo here for demonstration, and let's say we want to add more fog to it. So we are going to take the fog brush that we just created, then sample a color from the fog and start painting. Make sure you are using a low flow, and we want to take this nice and slow and gradually keep adding fog. Remember, fog has volume and detail, and you don't want to paint with the same brush size and flow. So I'm going to make the brush size a little bit smaller and then add smaller details. So at this point, we have our foundation. Now I can increase the flow just a little bit, and then take a brighter color from the fog and start painting more volume and detail, and that will make it much more realistic. Now this is the before and after, and as you can see, it looks very realistic, just like the fog from the image. Alright, now you have seen how much powerful this technique is. I hope you are seeing the potential of what you can do with it and use it on your own projects. Let me show you what I also did with this fog brush. This is a project that I did for an upcoming pro tutorial. Stay tuned for that, by the way. If you want to learn advanced compositing and retouching techniques, you can learn more by visiting my website at retouchstudio.com. And I used this exact brush technique to create this gloomy scene and add depth by creating multiple layers of fog. So I hope you have found this tutorial helpful, and if you did, make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel and also turn on notifications if you don't want to miss any new tutorials and techniques just like this one. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.